Lagrange multiplier methods. Now what we do in Lagrange multiplier methods means we will take the same example and the function is f of x, y, while the constraint is g of x, y is equal to some constant. Then, to apply the Lagrange multiplier, then the gradient, which is the partial derivative of f, the gradient of f x, y is equal to lambda times the gradient of g x, y, and this lambda is the same Lagrange multiplier which we are using over there. Here it is one restriction, we know this is one restriction, and that's why we will use lambda 1 f1. F1 is your restriction here. So now let's say we write the restriction, and the restriction is g of xy, which is given to us in terms of perimeter, and this is equal to 2x plus 2y is equal to 20. And now from here we will apply this condition, and this condition gives that curly f over curly x, if we are given two variables, this will be equal to lambda times curly g over curly x, and we will have curly f over curly y, means there are only two variables, equal lambda curly g over curly y. These are our two derivatives is for the equation. And now if I do find these things, you know what is called f of xy, or f of xy is equal to x times y. So what about if I take the derivative of this one, then what I will get? I will get here curly f over curly x, I will get y here, is equal to lambda times the derivative of this with respect to x, and the derivative of this with respect to x will become 2 and multiplied with lambda. Because when I take the derivative of this with respect to x, then it will become 2 plus 0 plus 0 equal to 0 here, right? So the derivative of this comes out to be 2 lambda. Similarly, if I take the derivative of f with respect to y, then it will come out to be x. And this is equal, you take the derivative of this with respect to y, and this will come 2. And 2 times lambda. So we are getting lambda equals y over 2 and lambda equals x over 2. It means that lambda is, it means that y over 2 is equal to lambda is equal to x over 2. And what does this gives you? This gives you that x and y are equal, right? X and y are equal. So you got the values of x and y to be the same, and now go to your constraint, this one. And what the constraint is saying, 2x times 2y, so for y I write x, and this gives 20, and here 2x plus 2x becomes 4x, 4 by 20, and x becomes 5. If x is 5, then y becomes 5. You got this great thing? That the things that we understood here, that we are maximizing the function, they we apply with the help of Lagrange multiplier. And Lagrange multiplier give the same result, x is equal to 5, y is equal to 5, and the area is maximum only 325, for which the coordinates to be equal. You can try all other coordinates, all other dimensions, they will not give you the maximum area under this constraint. Okay, you got it. So this method is the one which is called the general calculus method, and this is due to the reason that you know here that we very easily expected y from here to be 10 minus x. We will have the situation in which we will not be able to extract y there easily, then the general calculus will not work. Why the Lagrange multiplier will work? Because you know here we didn't extract the way. We just applied the Lagrange, you can say, relation, and we got the value to be equal to this, right? And this is the way that we will apply on the Lagrange, on the function, on these functions, on these configurations, and we will maximize these configurations. So we will write now to our cube, we will maximize this one, and for this we will write our function. The function in terms of g equals the function lambda 1 f1 lambda 2 f2 means all the constraints, and our function is equal. G is then defined is that this is something we define is q plus means our function, and then our Lagrange multiplier first, lambda 1, I am taking is it's a constant, so I am taking it as alpha, and the very first constraint is what? This one, that n minus summation on nn is equal to 0, so n minus summation on nn is here, plus another constant, because we are adding another constraint, so another Lagrange multiplier will come in here, and this is E minus summation on I and M N E M. This is understood that this is summation from I to infinity, so I will not write it again and again, and this is our function. Now we will have to treat this one. Here you know what is our purpose. Our purpose is to maximize this way, to maximize this configuration, and this will then we will call is the most probable configuration. Like we are arranging the particles in some levels. What will be the most probable configuration that you measure the probability of it and it will have the maximum probability? So it is here. Now there is one thing that we will have to focus. If I look here, our Q here and here is in the product form. These are products like tiles from one of this. And here a product and here a product. Now it is very difficult to treat a function in a product form. So what we will do a mathematical trick. And we will convert this Q from the product form to the summation form. And how to do this thing, convert this from product to summation, we will use the tactics of taking log of this function. You know that if, for example, Q is in the terms of Mn, means in a product, and you take log Q, then it is equal to log M, so natural log, log M plus log N. So from the product, you have converted this thing into summation. And, okay, and here, If I apply log on this one, log cube, then whether I will be doing something mathematically right or not, there's a question. So I will have to look at q in log of q. If I take q and log of q, where this thing will be mathematically right or not? Because here I am maximizing q, and here I am maximizing log of q. So whether it is mathematically right or not. So for this one, we know that q is a function. What about log q? Means you take log of that thing. Like x is a function. If you take log of x, so both these x and log of x are called the monotonous functions. Monotonous. These are monotonous functions. Mono means singletonous, means the tone, like single tone functions. We say monotonous functions are the functions which are ever increasing or ever decreasing functions. Like there are no variations. There are no variations in it. In a time it is increasing and then it will decrease and then some combination of increase and decrease. No. A monotonous function, monotonous, means in English we say that this is something monotonous, that this is a single tone line. This is something which is giving lack of variation, lack of versatility. So we call such functions as monotonous functions. And monotonous functions, there are, you can say, different functions, like x is ever increasing function. Log of x, like you can plot here. This is x function, and this is log of x will come somewhere here. So they are both monotonous. They are ever increasing function. There is no, you can say, variation in this one. It's a single tone function. So it will cause no effect. It will cause no effect if I maximize q or I maximize log of q. It will be the same thing. So I write here log of q, because this is just decreasing the effort I will do in my mathematics. And to do this thing, now my equation is ready. And this equation you will have to keep in mind that this is your lambda 1. And this is your lambda 2. This is your constraint 1, which is F1. And this is your constraint 2, which is F2. And here, this is your function, capital F, and this is the G, and we will apply something like this. If I differentiate this G with respect to alpha, and with respect to beta, and I just equate them equal to zero, right? Curly G by curly alpha. Then this thing with respect to alpha is zero. What about this one? With respect to alpha, then it will come out this way equal to zero. And it will come out to be n equal to summation of n and if curly beta by this, I do and I will get the constraints back. So by doing this thing as equating them equal to zero, I will just get the constraints. And those I already know. So it means differentiating it with respect to alpha and beta is making no sense here. Means they are giving us the constraints that we already know. So it means that we will go for curly G over curly MN. This is what we need. And now let's start here. Because our xn here, you know, our xn here is this one defined as nn. So this is our variable with respect to which I will be differentiating this one.